If confirmed, each of you will be dispatched to regions that are in deep turmoil right now and that are beset by multiple crises. In Europe, as everyone knows, Russia has launched an unprovoked war, the largest land war that the continent has seen since World War II. Our allies face incalculable harm, and the existence of Ukraine hangs in the balance. In the Middle East, the Iranian regime has flooded the region with terrorism and violence, has seized control of entire countries, such as Lebanon, and seeks to build a nuclear arsenal that I believe there's an unacceptably high risk they would use against Israel or indeed against the American homeland. Many of these crises are self-inflicted. Since the earliest days of the Biden administration, Biden-Harris officials have pursued policies all but explicitly designed to weaken our allies and to embolden our enemies. In Europe, the Biden administration spent much of 2021 undercutting our Ukrainian allies militarily, economically, and diplomatically. The president inexplicably issued waivers for Nord Stream 2, providing Putin with an alternative route to send gas to Europe and exposing Ukraine to the existential conflict it is now facing. The administration at least twice withheld lethal assistance from our Ukrainian allies, aid they would have trained with and now be using, all in an effort to grease relations with Russia. Biden-Harris officials denied President Zelensky an early, critical meeting with President Biden in order to try to coerce his approval for such policies. And of course, on the eve of war, State Department officials were dispatched to offer broad concessions to Russia that would have crippled NATO. And once they became public, that signaled weakness to both our allies and our adversaries. The State Department went so far as to pressure the Ukrainians to cede territory to Russia, the literal definition of European appeasement. At times like this, we need every ally we can find. But unfortunately, across the globe, the Biden administration has alienated many of our traditional allies. Yesterday, this committee heard testimony about India from Assistant Secretary Liu. India is a critical ally across a number of areas, and the U.S.-Indian alliance has broadened and deepened in recent years. But under the Biden administration, it's gone backwards. Yesterday, in a United Nations General Assembly vote condemning Putin's aggression, the Indians abstained rather than stand with us against Russia. And today, there are reports that the Biden administration is contemplating imposing CATSA sanctions against India, the largest democracy on earth, a decision that I think would be extraordinarily foolhardy. India is not the only country to have voted against us and against condemning Russia. The United Arab Emirates also abstained in yesterday's vote. The UAE is a close ally of the United States, and during the Trump administration was a critical player in the Abraham Accords that fundamentally transformed the entire Middle East and brought Israelis and Arabs together under American leadership. When the Biden administration took over, however, they made it a week one priority to tilt away from our regional allies and towards Iran. And they immediately dismantled terrorism sanctions on the Iran-controlled Houthis in Yemen. The Houthis, of course, didn't wait a day before escalating their attacks. And they eventually started launching terrorist attacks into the UAE itself. Critically, this week and this weekend, the Biden administration is looking to lock in their pivot towards Iran at breathtaking danger to our Middle East allies and to the United States itself. There are reports from Vienna that a new agreement from Iran will be announced imminently. This deal is nothing short of catastrophic. And I fully anticipate that the Biden administration will attempt to circumvent congressionally mandated review of the deal. The deal will provide Iran with a functionally unlimited nuclear program, facilitate the development of ICBMs, dismantle sanctions related to terrorism and human rights, and pour hundreds of billions of dollars into the regime's coffer. A regime headed by a theocratic Ayatollah who chants death to America and death to Israel is on the verge of being massively funded by President Joe Biden.